Hi, I'm Steve Arbour, Learning Officer at Strangers Hall Museum in Norwich, and we are going to talk about fire. The year is 1507. Disaster struck as half the houses in Norwich burnt within 2 years during the Great Fires of Norwich. Over 100 years later, in 1666, London suffered the same fate, when a third of the city burned for nearly 5 days and over 100,000 people were made homeless. Now, you may know that the Great Fire of London might have started in a bakery on Pudding Lane, but there were lots of accidental fires in the past. Most houses in the past were made of wood, with a roof made of reeds and straw called thatch. But people deliberately lit fires inside them. Now, people in the past were very scared of fire because it could cause a lot of damage, and sometimes people even died from it. So, why would someone ever light a fire in their wooden house? Doesn't seem to make sense. Well, let's have a look at what fire is used for. Before the days of electricity, which has only been available in normal homes for about 100 years, and that of course means no TV, no mobile phones, no computer, and no toaster. Everyone cooked their food with fire, heated their homes with fire, and got light in their homes using candles, which are effectively sticks of wax, on fire. If you were living in the past, you basically had to make the choice each evening between living in the cold and dark, like I am here, or lighting small fires so you could see and stay warm. People did all kinds of things to try to make their fires safe, but sometimes accidents happened. Now, many of you have had candles, I'm sure, on your birthday cake. They're fun, aren't they? And they're pretty. But just think what life would be like if the only light you had to see by in the evening was that of a candle. Okay, we're going to go through a few different lighting effects together. Try out some different lighting at home, maybe. If you can have a go with some real candles, that's great, but make sure you have an adult to help you because, as I've said, fire can be very dangerous. Have any of you ever seen what a room looks like when it's only lit by candles? Can you imagine what it must have been like to try and write a letter to a friend by candlelight? Just think how many candles you would need to light a room completely. It's just so dark everywhere outside of the candle. You may be able to see my face and possibly a little bit down here on the table, but so dark everywhere else. Okay, let's light a couple more candles. One, two. Okay, so it's much brighter now with three candles burning. I wonder if any of you know what this is. Now, I'm going to just turn on an electric light, just let you see what it looks like a bit, so I can show you this, because this is a little oil lamp. And in the days before wax candles, oil lamps were all the rage. Let's just light that. A little lamp that you can take with you. Pop our oil in the top here. A little flame burns as you walk through your house. Any of you use oil lamps in your homes? Probably not. Let's blow that one out. Okay, let's try some different lights then, because we've got these really nice yellow lights, sort of yellowy orangey flame. Let's try something a little bit more modern. Let's try a mobile phone torch. Let's see what that's like. Oh, that's a bit dazzling and white and glary, isn't it? It's much brighter, but it's also a much harsher, whiter light. It doesn't look nearly as cozy as these candles did. Okay, let's turn that off. It's unpleasant. Okay, that's better. Right. Okay. So we've had a quick look at the table lamp here. We've seen what the room's like. Let me just remind you what that's light. It is light. What that's like. So it's much brighter, much easier to write your letters if you're going to be writing your letter to your aunt. So you can see what you're doing. I think though, what we need to do now is I'm going to turn this off and we're going to turn on the lights in the room. And we're just going to see how much brighter it is. In kind of a modern evening setting. Okay, are you ready? 3, 2, 1. Wow, that's really, really bright, isn't it? I mean, all the shadows have gone from it. Well, I mean, there are still shadows, of course, from the lights, but it's not dark in the corners of the room anymore. It's bright. You can see what you're doing. So I want you to think then. It takes so many candles to light a room like this. If you were going to hold a party or a banquet, a big dinner, and you lived in the days before electricity, just think how many candles you would need. And we've got three fairly good sized candles here burning and it was still really dark. It's no wonder that fire was such a big problem in the past, with houses made of wood, little fires burning all over the place. It's not surprising that people were so frightened of fire. So, next time you turn on the light in your room, remember how much more difficult and dangerous this was in the past.